much. Milestones Autism Researchers does a lot of incredible work here in Northeast Ohio. It improves the lives of autistic individuals, families, and caregivers through education and resources. And they're celebrating 20 wonderful years. With me now, founders Eliana Hoffer Scarf and Mia Buckwall Gillis is with us this morning to talk about this amazing 20-year milestone. Congratulations, ladies.
Thank you.
Let's start from the very beginning. We always hear about, you know, autism, but in a nutshell, what is it? What are we talking about here?
Autism is a spectrum. Mm-hmm. It affects each individual differently. It affects their communication skills, their social skills, their behavior, as well as often some sensory issues as well.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about your individual stories and how you guys met.
We both have children who, at the time, were seeing a speech therapist, mm-hmm. and we would run by each other, and eventually we actually slowed down enough to talk to each other, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. and started talking. And
slowed down enough to talk to each other.
Yeah, we were running after our little kids running past each other.
Yeah. What type of pressure is there on a family and on parents when you have an autistic child or an autistic person in the family?
You know, I think that it starts from this lack of knowledge, mm-hmm. feeling you don't know what's the right thing to do.
Okay.
Feeling like what are the resources? You know, when you go to a play group and it's not working, mm-hmm. what do you do? When you try to go to the library or a restaurant, mm-hmm. and it's hard to have those typical family activities. But what we found was finding each other, having someone to bounce ideas off each other, as well as the education, knowing what strategies to work for our kids, really made a huge difference.
Lots of things have changed in the last 20 years, would you say?
Yes.
For the better, I would think, huh?
Yes.
There are so many resources here now. People really know how to work with children with autism, mm-hmm. and we're also hearing so much more from autistic individuals as they are adults. Okay. They're sharing a lot of information.
Mm-hmm. Now, I know that there's a lot on the parents, but what about the other members of the family? Do they have to also have to understand what's going on, and should they be schooled in how to deal with things?
Yes, I think that makes a tremendous difference, mm-hmm. because, you know, one of the feelings one has when you have a child who's different, who mm-hmm. learns differently, mm-hmm. who reacts differently mm-hmm. to the world, mm-hmm. is you feel isolated. You feel like you're the only one going through this, and really having the whole family behind you makes a big difference, and not just the family, but the teachers.
What kind of resources do you guys offer?
Through Milestones. Mm-hmm. We have a free help desk for people. We have an online resources, including our new MAP tool, that goes through the steps one can take and learn to achieve independence and greater proficiency.
And that's the key, independence, if you can. That's the ultimate goal.
Really, the key is interdependence. If you think about how each of us lives every day, I'm not completely independent.
Right.
My husband helps grocery shop and mm-hmm. makes dinner, and mm-hmm. if not, we wouldn't be here 20 mm-hmm. years later mm-hmm. with a successful nonprofit mm-hmm. organization helping so many people, because it takes a whole family.
What's the biggest challenge for a family, would you say?
There are different challenges along the way. Education, engagement in the community, as well as when you're looking ahead, should you go the path of higher education or employment? Mm-hmm. And these things are possibilities. Mm-hmm. I think one of the things that really impacts us and makes us feel so gratified to be in this work and helping other people is showing them their opportunities.
Do you have to look for what, say, the autistic child, do you have to look for what that child can do best and try to emphasize that? Is that one way to look at the situation?
Absolutely. You want to build on strengths.
On strengths, yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Strengths and interests.
And interests.
Right.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
And you could use those interests to teach about anything and to learn about anything and build over time on those interests.
My goodness gracious. Talk about the anniversary celebration and all of that. It's coming up pretty soon, isn't
it? It's coming up this Thursday.
Yeah,
it's really a wonderful time for us to reflect and to thank the community. And it'll be this Thursday at Landerhaven.
At Landerhaven, yeah. What are you most proud of?
I'm most proud of all the families that we've been able to help over the years.
How many would you say? This is just a guess.
Thousands.
Thousands
of families.
Wow.
Thousands.
And this started when you guys just met each other, and I mean, it just blossomed. Huh? It's a beautiful thing. You guys are doing a wonderful work. You really, really are. And congratulations, 20 years.
Thank you.
That is absolutely amazing. And the progress has been wonderful, too, as far as dealing with autism and stuff like that. Very, very.
Oh, yeah.
Thank goodness for that. You guys are wonderful. Thank you so much for stopping by, and congratulations for what you've done and all of that. Once again, the Milestones 20th anniversary benefit is this Thursday, October 27th, 5 o'clock, Lander Haven. It's going to be a wonderful event. And once again, appreciate you guys and everything you do.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.